Sheila.
Oi, Ms. Sheila!
Hi, girl!
Hello, welcome back. It's nice to see you. Kamusta naman?
Good to be here.
Ganda-ganda. Have a seat anywhere. Wherever you want. Oo,
nice to be back.
Oo, matagal-tagal. Yes. Pero nagkausap tayo sa radio mga 2 weeks ago.
It was fun.
And nabitin kasi yung usapan natin doon. And I was wondering nga kung ano yung, kasi si Kikay nabanggit niya sa akin na yung meron siyang friend na mag-a-abroad. And of course, parang plano rin niya mag-aral ng language kung saan siya pupunta. Mm-mm. So, ano ba yung mga benefits sa learning new language?
Well, it makes us globally competitive, for one. And as a matter of fact, our Department of Education is on the right track kasi ini-introduce na nila yung mga foreign languages dun sa K-12 program.
Uh-uh.
But because of the limited exposure of students, more or less 4 hours a week, we will not get the sufficient exposure to the foreign language.
Mm-hmm.
Nevertheless, whenever you learn a foreign language, another language, you develop your cognitive skills.
It's always an advantage.
Pero
ano ba yung foreign language na in demand? Kasi if I can remember it correctly, pag kinukwentuhan ako ng mommy ko, dandun sa curriculum nila at that time, ewan ko kung kasama na ni Kong yun, yung Spanish class.
Mm-mm.
Pero ngayon require, kasi...
Hindi naman kwan yun parang... Well, how would you say it? It was not voluntary. It was really...
It's not compulsory.
Not compulsory because since we were a part of Spain before, diba?
Before.
Kaya, yan
kaya ganun. So, parang at some point talaga, at that time, merong talaga silang natututunan ng ibang language. But ngayon, ano ba yung mga in-demand na foreign language na pwedeng matutunan ng mga... students.
Well, Spanish is still
Spanish
one.
Spanish is still
because historically, talagang maraming na colonized na territories ang Spain. And among the European languages, there's French and German.
German.
We also have Japanese.
Mm-hmm. If you go by population, Chinese.
And Chinese.
Yes.
Mandarin Chinese particularly. Then of course, yung bagong inintroduce ngayon sa Department of Education, yung Korean. Not necessarily spoken worldwide or not yet a global business language, but because there are a lot of Filipinos who are into K-pop.
So
not only Filipinos, it's a worldwide trend.
The motivation to learn Korean is high. And so we have to harness that because that's another matter to consider. Mm-hmm. Para mas effective yung pag-acquire natin ng second language.
My son took as an elective German and he got an A for it and then he minored in Korean studies. So he has 3 languages if ever.
Wow,
diba?
Ang galing, multilingual. Yeah. Pero tulad niyan, katulad ng anak ni Kong, diba? Ano ba yung nagiging parang naitutulong sa isang individual kapag marami kang alam na language?
Well, first of all, among Filipinos, may edge na tayo. Mm-hmm. Because you know Filipino, or based on our dialect,
English.
Tagalog, and then English. Mm-hmm. The situation when you're learning a foreign language is that there is something called interlanguage, Angela.
Mm-hmm.
That is the language that's between the first language and then the target language.
Mm-hmm.
So, meron kang transition. And because of that transition, you enhance your comprehension, you enhance your aptitude.
Mm-hmm.
Ang benefit, of course, you become more confident, you become more adept. Mas based on research, mas tumataas even the mathematical skills.
Ah, really?
Oo, of those who are exposed to a foreign language. I think given that we have that advantage, parents and educators should also be mindful of the downside of exposing our kids to a foreign language without mastery of a first language. Because research has also shown that if the person is exposed to a foreign language without first understanding or mastering the first language, he will not be good in either one.
Bale, wala. Kumbaga parang wala yung foundation.
Yeah.
Diba? But kanina po, Ms. Sheila, nabanggit nyo about K-12, na magkakaroon na dun sa ating curriculum yung pagkuha nga ng foreign language, which is I think yung kanilang ano is yung Korean, ano. Pero paano natin matutulungan itong mga K-12 students na makapamili ng foreign language? Kasi saying na newly introduced lang to us.
There are several languages that they can choose from. And there is a certain standard kasi the classes that that are introduced by DepEd are limited. So given that kung hindi ma-qualify yung bata dun sa mga programang yan, there are a lot of training centers like TalkShop. We offer foreign language training. As a matter of fact, what we're keen about is that we want the native speakers to teach the foreign language to Filipinos, because there are intricacies, you know, yung mga meaning of the language that can be compromised if it's not a native speaker teaching the language. If you are interested in a particular culture, in a particular language, that's what you pursue. But at the same time, being exposed to a foreign language, because it advances your skills, your learning skills and your aptitude, maganda ring maipush dun sa mga bata. So even if there's no immediate opportunity to go abroad or to interact with foreign with the native speakers of the target foreign language,
at maganda ring encourage. It's an advantage talaga, no?
That's
kung
right.
Nagkaroon ng demand for that specific language or for that specific language na may kailangan na trabaho.
Yeah. Plus the orientation to learn. Because definitely, the best skill to learn will always be the skill to learn.
Oo. Pero di ba sinasabi nga nila, Ms. Sheila, it's never too late to learn new things, diba? Explore things, ganyan-ganyan. But then again, sinasabi din nila, kapag mas bata, mas madaling turuan. Mas mabilis turuan. But paano naman in your experience, Ms. Sheila, yung mga at our age, growing up, di ba? Paano? Ano yung challenges?
Di ba? Hindi niya sinabi at the age of COVID.
Oh, di ba? Mabait ako ngayon kasi Monday.
First working day.
Napaka-ano.
But going back po. Yeah. So what are the challenges that you usually encounter when you teach mga medyo mature people?
Okay. So when it comes to language learning and language acquisition, it's easier for kids to acquire the target foreign language.
So what do you say, diba? Start them young. Diba yun
start them young. Particularly before the age of 15, so bago mag-puberty. But if you compare the much younger children and those who are mga 9 up to 13, 14, 15, those who are age 9 up to 15, mas maganda yung comprehension nila. Kasi solid na yung understanding nila of their native language. However, it shouldn't stop us from exposing much younger children to different languages. Because research has shown that kids at that age, 2 up to 7, can learn at least 7 languages.
Oh, kasi easily. Yung brain nila is like a sponge daw that absorbs everything, diba?
Yes. Supposedly. And eventually they acquire the right accent. Madali silang kumuha ng accent, but if you try to figure out, you know, how our uncles, mga aunts natin who migrated to the U.S. sound, even after 10 years of staying in that country, yung accent nila pareho. Because that's what happens when the learning happens after puberty. So after 15. Ngayon, in our case, whenever we're teaching foreign language, we definitely consider yung motivation and then yung proficiency level nung
tsaka, of course, yung interest ng estudyante.
Yes.
Diba? Kasi kung walang interest, medyo mahirap siya ipa-focus doon sa kung anong language yung tinuturo.
Yes.
Tama po ba?
And the reason is born out of, the reason for the interest is kung ano yung intention niya. Usually, may mga kaibigan who speak that language or mag-a-abroad or may pupuntahan sa abroad. Those are good motivations. But simply to learn the language, that's also good. But definitely interaction plays a big role.
So ano-ano po ba yung mga foreign language that you teach sa TalkShop?
From all European languages, all Asian languages. i-consider mo na lang ano ba talagang language mm-hmm. ang interested kang matutunan, saan ka pupunta. And
okay.
then, ganong kagwapo yung gusto mong consultant.
Pero Sheila,
pati yung itsura Sheila, ng instructor.
Important dito is yung kwan eh, yung practice eh, di ba?
Yeah.
You have That's someone right. to always converse
to.
With.
Mm-hmm.
No? Kasi kung hindi eh, you can Wala. Also lose the
Yes.
language.
There's a danger of language attrition. So bumababa yung confidence mo and also your comprehension of the language that you learned without the proper exposure.
Uh-oh. And then aside from yung work reason mo to learn yung language, also if you're a frequent traveler, it's also good to learn new language kasi para kung saan ka pupunta, mm-hmm. alam mo yung language na
yes.
hindi ka pa ano-ano, di ba?
It's easy to immerse in that
yeah,
culture
exactly.
if you know a few phrases, mm-hmm. yung mga kung paano mag-thank you, mm-hmm. kung paano mag-greet.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. But age or lack of travel opportunity mm-hmm. should not stop anyone from
yes.
learning a foreign language. It's a good hobby mm-hmm. to have. Like, pag nabobore ka, mag-foreign language ka.
Ayun.
Kasi that's how you develop your cognitive skills consistently.
All right. On that note, Ms. Sheila, ano po ba yung website ng TalkShop for more mm-hmm. details?
For more details, they can get in touch with us at 894-5588. Mm-hmm. And then the website is www.talkshop.ph.
Yeah. Thank you very much, Ms. Sheila Viesca, ang CEO and Director ng TalkShop.
And
it's
thank
always
you,
nice
Angel.
Talking to you.
Yes, Kong, thank
yes.
you very much.
Thank you.
It's good to be back. Wow.